Ugh.
Doctor, Dr. Chakwas,
What a horrible
I think he's
dream.
waking up.
You had us worried there, Shepard. How are you feeling?
I mean, you know. What happened?
How did I end up here? How long was I out?
About 15 hours. Something happened down there with the beacon, I think.
It's my fault. I
it is.
Triggered some kind of security.
You're absolutely correct.
You had to push me out of the way.
Where's the beacon now? What happened to it?
The beacon exploded. A system overload, maybe. The blast knocked you cold. The lieutenant and I carried you back here to the ship.
Arigato. Ooh, look at those sexy
Physically,
eyes.
You're fine. But I
mentally, you're fucked.
Unusual brain activity. Abnormal beta waves. I also noticed an increase in your rapid eye movement.
Nice.
Signs typically associated with intense dreaming.
Good old REM sleep.
I saw... I'm not sure what I saw. Death? Destruction? Nothing's really clear.
Sounds like a typical Friday night for me.
Oh, Captain Anderson.
How's our XO holding up, Doctor?
Well, all the readings look normal. I'd say the command is going...
What does XO stand for?
Glad to hear it.
XO.
Shepard, I need to speak with you.
In private. Oh.
Aye, aye, Captain. I'll be in the mess.
Xenophile officer. Wait, xenophile? Is that like pedophile but with aliens? Hang on. What am I saying? What? Why's Williams here, mate?
Williams isn't part of the Normandy crew.
I figured we could use a soldier like her. She's been reassigned to the Normandy.
Yeah, sure.
Williams is a good soldier. She deserves it.
Lieutenant Alenko agrees with you. That's why I added her to our crew.
Intel dropped the ball, sir. We had no idea what we were walking into down there. That's why things went to hell.
Yeah, that's why.
Outside the veil in 2 centuries.
Of course.
Nobody could have predicted this.
You said you needed to see me in private, Captain?
I won't lie to you, Shepard.
Good. I mean, I'll lie to you, but I'm glad you won't lie to me.
The beacon was destroyed and Geth are invading. The Council's going to want answers.
Fuck the Council.
The Council can kiss my ass. I won't let them blame me for losing the beacon. I didn't do anything wrong.
I'll stand behind you and your report, Shepard. You're a damned hero in my books.
That's right. Don't you forget Torfan.
That other Turian.
Only anyone forget Torfan.
One of the best. A living legend. But if he's working with the Geth, it means he's gone rogue. A rogue Spectre's trouble. Saren's dangerous. And he hates humans.
He hates humans?
He thinks we're growing too fast, taking over the galaxy.
It's like he's a Taurian or something.
Most of them don't do anything about it.
If you're wondering why Taurians and humans don't really get along, it's because there was a war long ago. First Contact War, I believe it was called. And we killed each other. It was great. Fantastic. Highly recommend it.
Did you see anything? Any clue that might tell us what Saren was after?
No.
Just before I lost.
Absolutely not.
I had some kind of vision.
There's a lot of death and screaming and
a vision.
Quick clips.
A vision of what?
War! War is coming.
Geth, maybe. Slaughtering people. Butchering them.
Sexy.
We need to report this to the Council, Shepard.
Fuck off.
They'll think I'm crazy.
We don't know what information was stored in that beacon. Lost Prothean technology? Blueprints for some ancient weapon of mass destruction?
Dude! I wish it was.
Saren took it. But I know Saren. I know his reputation, his politics. He believes humans are a blight on the galaxy. This attack was an act of war. He has the secrets from the beacon. He has an army of Geth at his command, and he won't stop until he's wiped humanity from the face of the galaxy.
I'll stop him.
I'll find some way to take him down.
It's not that easy. He's a Spectre. He can go anywhere, do almost anything.
I mean, that's but he's a rogue Spectre. Surely his powers will get taken away, yeah? No? No? They can't help us.
When have they ever done anything for humanity?
Racist! Saren as a traitor. I love race politics. It's the best. I love them in my video games all the time.
See if he can get us an audience with the Council. He'll want to see us as soon as we reach the Citadel. We should be getting close. Head up to the bridge and tell Joker to bring us into dock.
Yes, sir. Alright, now we're gonna head off to the Citadel. Nice, zero metagel replenished. Nailed it.
Hey, Commander.
Hey, Ashley.
I'm glad you're okay, Commander. The crew could use some good news after what happened to Jenkins.
Nah, he won't be. They shall not be missed.
When your number comes up, it's over. His did.
That's grim, Commander. I guess I shouldn't be surprised, though. Not after Torfin. That must have been hell.
You're starting to enjoy it? Holy shit. That was
I did what
sir.
I had to do. You'd better be willing to do the same.
I won't let the Alliance down, sir.
So how are you holding up? Like, just come off as this, like, no one caring asshole. I'm just like, hey, but how are you doing, though?
Comes with being a Marine. But to see my whole unit wiped out. And you never get used to seeing dead civilians. But things would have been a lot worse if you hadn't have shown up.
I mean, you helped. And you didn't help. The mission failed.
Dead Marines. Dead colonists. And in the end, we still didn't get that beacon.
Yeah, we suck.
You saved a lot of lives, Commander. It might be hard
yeah,
to keep that perspective.
Yeah, but no important lives. Yeah, save it.
I'm not looking for a shoulder to cry on, Williams. Just stay focused on your job.
Understood, sir.
Yeah, fuck off. Hey, Dr. Jockworth!
Yes, Commander? Is there something
you need?
How long you know the Lieutenant?
I'd never worked with him before this mission. But he has an impressive service record. Over a dozen special commendations. Tends to keep to himself, though. Maybe because of the headaches. It's not easy being an L2.
What does that have to do with it?
Well, most biotics now use the L3 implants. Lieutenant Alenko was wired with the old L2 configuration. Sometimes there are complications.
What kind of complications?
Severe mental disabilities, insanity, crippling physical pain.
Wow, it's horrific pretty symptoms. Severe.
Hayden's lucky. He just gets migraines.
Yeah. I'd hate to think what the L1 implants did. God damn.
What do you know about Captain Anderson?
Yeah, what do you know about Keith David?
Now. He knows when to let things slide and when to crack the whip. The crew knows he's seen pretty much anything they'll ever run into. And he cares about the people under his command.
How did you end up serving on an Alliance ship?
I enlisted right out of med school. Earth always seemed boring to me. Too safe. Too secure. I figured the colonies were teeming with exotic adventure.
And aliens and sexy fun times.
Of tough soldiers with piercing eyes and sensitive souls.
Wow.
Military life isn't quite as romantic as I'd imagined. But humanity needs the Alliance if we want to keep expanding through the Traverse. And the Alliance always needs good doctors. So I stayed on to do my part.
Any regrets?
You think you made the wrong choice?
Sometimes I think about opening a private practice back on Earth. Or maybe taking a position at one of the new med centers out in the colonies. But there's something special about working on soldiers. If I left the Alliance now, I'd feel like I was abandoning them.
Aww.
Goodbye.
How sweet. Goodbye, love. Hey, Caden!
Okay, Commander.
Okay, Caden does not want to talk. Ha ha ha. What's up, Captain?
You'll speak to Joker when you're ready.
Now, fuck off. Aha! What's up, Presley?
You're okay, Commander.
Okay, Presley.
Jenkins was hard enough on
the crew. Ah. Give me those sweet, sweet codexes. Ah, now for a very, very pretty cutscene.
Good timing, Commander. I was just about to bring us into the Citadel. See that taxpayer money at work.
Yeah, buddy. Now let's all quietly enjoy this. If you know what I mean.
Flagship of the Citadel fleet.
Well, size isn't everything.
Why so touchy, Joker?
I'm just saying you need firepower, too.
Look at that monster. Its main gun could rip through the barriers in any ship in the Alliance fleet.
Good thing it's on our side, then.
Citadel Control, this is SSV Normandy, requesting permission to land.
Stand by for clearance, Normandy. Clearance granted. You may begin your approach. Transferring you to an Alliance operator.
Roger, Alliance Tower. Normandy out.
Normandy, this is Alliance Tower. Please proceed to Dock 422.
Beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. And now we have to deal with the biggest dick in the Mass Effect universe.
Outrage! The Council would step in if the Geth attacked a Turian colony?
Aye.
The Turians don't found colonies on the borders of the Terminus systems, Ambassador.
Humanity was well aware of the risks when you went into the Traverse.
What about Saren? You can't just ignore a rogue Spectre. I demand action!
You don't get to make demands of the Council, Ambassador.
Citadel Security is investigating your charges against Saren. We will discuss the CSEC findings at the hearing, not before.
Captain Anderson, I see you brought half your crew with you.
Just the ground team from Eden Prime, in case you had any questions.
I have the mission reports. I assume they're accurate?
They are. Sounds like you convinced the Council to give us an audience.
They were not happy about it. Saren's their top agent. They don't like him being accused of treason.
They're
blind. I'm not gonna sit on my ass just because the Council doesn't want to do anything. If they won't stop Saren, I will.
Settle down, Commander. You've already done more than enough to jeopardize your candidacy for the Spectres. The mission on Eden Prime was a chance to prove you could get the job done. Instead, Nihilus ended up dead and the beacon was destroyed.
That's Saren's fault, not his.
Then we better hope the CSEC investigation turns up evidence to support our accusations. Otherwise, the Council might use this as an excuse to keep you out of the Spectres.
Oh no.
Come with me, Captain. I want to go over a few things before the hearing. Shepard, you and the others can meet us at the Citadel Tower, top level. I'll make sure you have clearance to get in.
And that's why I hate politicians.
Amen. Okey-dokey. Yes, thank you. Now, I believe I can do a bit of hacky-hacky. But first, let's save. Ba-ba-ba-da. Captain Hendrickson reported some unusual energy readings during a patrol of the Argos Rogue Cluster. She had particular concerns about the Hydra system, but was recalled before her team could investigate further. No patrols are scheduled for that set. Do we want to send in a recon team? I'll get sent in, mate. I'll do that shit. We're good. Now, the side quests all over this place, so I have to remember where the bloody hell to find them. Hey, man!
Sincere apology, but I am here on business and cannot be distracted right now.
Okay, what's wrong?
You seem distressed. Is there something I can do to help?
Alarmed response. You overheard that, did you?
No, but sure.
This is all going so wrong, and it is the Asari consort's fault. She's the one who started all this.
What did this Asari do to get you so upset?
I cannot speak more about this problem. It is too sensitive. Suffice it to say,
I love these aliens.
She has compromised my authority as a diplomat.
Where is she?
Where can I find this Asari consort?
She is across the bridge from here. Her offices are in the spot. Good day.
Good day. Okay, moving on. Oh, hello.
Welcome. I am Nalina. I don't recognize you as one of our expected clients today. Would you like me to see when the consort will be able to meet with you?
Can't I just go in?
I'm afraid not.
You silly human.
There are many who seek the consort services. But if you wish to leave your name, she'll make every effort to meet with you.
What do you do here, Nalina?
I'm one of the consort's acolytes.
Pretty clear.
Many of the people here today will not see the consort, but they expect to be attended to just the same.
Heyo.
It's our job to ensure that they leave contented.
What exactly do you attend to?
Well, each acolyte has her unique abilities. Some soothe with song, others with conversation. As much as possible, we seek to match the needs of our clients to the skills of our acolytes. My specialty is touch. My fingertips can find every tension point in your body and relieve it.
Nice.
I'd like to try out your services.
Excellent. We're glad to our client list. We shall be able to see you in 3 or 4 months.
Wow.
Nobody's worth that much of a wait.
Well, that's not for me to judge. I have your name and you'll be contacted. Is there anything else?
What is the consort? What does she do?
It's difficult to explain. She's many things to many people, and something different for each. Some seek her for advice, some for entertainment, others still for pleasure.
Heyo.
Most of the time, our clients won't realize what they were seeking until after she has provided it for them.
Nice. She mystical.
You made her sound like some kind of oracle.
No, not in the usual sense. She's merely a woman. A woman with remarkable compassion and a generous spirit. I suggest you make an appointment and see for yourself.
I think I'm done here.
Oh, well, I hope you'll return again in the future. We always enjoy seeing new clients.
Nalina.
Yes, Shaira?
Send the commander up to see me. I wish to speak with him.
Yes, of course, mistress.
Ooh, baby. Look at that walk. Damn.
Huh. It appears the consort has taken notice of you.
I mean, damn
She'd
straight.
Like to meet with you now.
I'm Dragon Lord Shepard, you know? Sure.
Where do I go?
Just head upstairs. She'll be waiting for you.
Okay. Hello.
I see even the humans find the consort irresistible.
This is my first time. I can't believe I didn't come sooner.
All right, Darth Vader.
You're with the Alliance?
Huh,
my
human.
Private back on Earth.
Wow, private, eh? Hello. A nice beard. That's a nice beard. I mean, that's a couch.
That is
so.
Close enough, Commander.
What?
I've heard a great many things about you since your arrival here in our citadel.
You checking up on me?
I don't like people spying on me.
I apologize, Commander. I make it my business to know when important people arrive on the station. Many of them become clients.
Mm-hmm.
But that is not why I asked you here. I have a certain problem that could use your expertise.
Maybe I can help.
I have a friend, Septimus.
Yes, friend.
I won't discuss the details, but he wanted me to be more than I could be. We had a falling out. Now he spends his days in Korra's den.
Good old Korra's den.
If you would speak to him as a fellow soldier, I believe he will listen to you and let the matter be.
What happened between you?
I respect his privacy too much to go into the details. If he wishes to tell you what happened, that is his prerogative.
Yeah, right.
What exactly do you want me to tell him?
Appeal to his sense of honor. Remind him of his position as a general. If you can convince him to stop spreading lies about me, I would be very grateful.
Yeah? How grateful?
Now I must ask you to take your leave.
Ah.
I have many clients waiting to see me.
Yeah, you're very, like, hot and cold, aren't you? Yeah, bitch. Bye, guys. Have fun. Ah! They can teleport. Madness. Oh, I think I see one of my favorite characters. Hello. Garrus.
Saren's hiding something. Give me more time. Stall them.
Stall the council? Don't be ridiculous. Your investigation is over, Garrus.
Commander Shepard, Garrus Vakarian. I was the officer in charge of the CSEC investigation into Saren.
Who was that?
Who were you just talking to?
That was Executor Palin. head of Citadel Security, my boss.
And kind of an asshole.
My findings on Saren to the Council.
Come across anything I should know about?
Saren's a Spectre. Most of his activities are classified. I couldn't find anything solid. But I know he's up to something. Like you humans say, I feel it in my gut.
I think the Council's ready for us, Commander.
Good luck, Shepard. Maybe they'll listen to you.
I mean, they won't. I'm human. You had a much better chance. Hello.
The hearing's already started. Come on.
The Geth attack is a matter of some concern, but there is nothing to indicate Saren was involved in any way.
The investigation by Citadel Security turned up no evidence to support your charge of treason.
Well,
eyewitness saw him kill Nihlus in cold blood.
We've read the Eden Prime reports, Ambassador. The testimony of one traumatized dock worker is hardly compelling proof.
I resent these accusations. Nihlus was a fellow Spectre and a friend.
You liar.
You catch him off guard.
Captain Anderson, you always seem to be involved when humanity makes false charges against me.
Well.
And this must be your protege, Commander Shepard.
Hello.
The one who let the beacon get destroyed.
The mission to Eden Prime was top secret. The only way you could know about the beacon was if you were there.
With Nihlus gone, his files passed on to me. I read the Eden Prime report. I was unimpressed. But what can you expect from a human?
You asshole.
You can expect me to kill you.
Damn! Alright, maybe ease up a little bit. Like a threat against, you know, Spectre. Not great.
You're not even ready to join the Spectres.
He has no right to say that. That's not his decision.
Shepard's admission into the Spectres is not the purpose of this meeting.
This meeting has no purpose. The humans are wasting your time, Counselor, and mine.
Arrogant bastard!
You can't hide behind the Council forever.
There is still one outstanding issue. Commander Shepard's vision. It may have been triggered by the beacon.
Are we allowing dreams into evidence?
Yeah, even I knew this was not a good idea.
My innocence against this kind of testimony.
I agree. Our judgment must be based on facts and evidence, not wild imaginings and reckless speculation.
Do you have anything else to add, Commander Shepard?
What's the point?
You've made your decision. I won't waste my breath.
The Council has found no evidence of any connection between Saren and the Geth. Ambassador, your petition to have him disbarred from the Spectres is denied.
I'm glad to see justice was served.
This meeting is adjourned.
That's kind of surprising. There's no, like, repercussions over this false accusation of treason. I mean, from the Council's side, it's like, seems a little weird. Like, ah, those silly humans just, you know, using our best Spectre of being traitor.
It made the Council question our motives.
I know Saren. He's working with the Geth for one reason. To exterminate the entire human race. Every colony we have is at risk. Every world we control is in danger. Even Earth isn't safe.
Not Earth!
We need to deal with Saren ourselves.
As a Spectre, he's virtually untouchable. We need to find some way to expose him.
What about Garrus, that CSEC investigator? We saw him arguing with the Executor.
That's right. He was asking for more time to finish his report. Seems like he was close to finding something on Saren.
Yeah.
Any idea where we could find him?
The bar!
Contact in CSEC who can help us track Garrus down. His name is Harkin.
Forget it. They suspended Harkin last month, drinking on the
Yep. Bar.
I won't waste my time with that loser.
You won't have to. I don't want the Council using your past history with Saren as an excuse to ignore anything we turn up. Shepard will handle this.
Hey, Keith David deserves better.
You can't just cut Captain Anderson out of this investigation.
The Ambassador's right. I need to step aside.
I need to take care of some business. Captain, meet me in my office later.
Harkin's probably getting drunk at Cora's den.
Yeah.
It's a little club in the lower section of the wards.
I thought you said he was a drunken loser.
Couldn't hurt to go talk to him. Just be careful. I wouldn't call him reliable.
You and Saren have a history. What happened?
About 20 years ago, I was part of a mission in the Skillian Verge.
Oh, I love the Skillian Verge.
Saren to find and remove a known terrorist threat. Saren eliminated his target. But a lot of people died along the way. Innocent people. And the official records just covered it all up.
Well, yeah.
I saw how he operates.
But then, I mean, my backstory, I kind of did the same thing, right? Like, I used my soldiers and got them all killed. You know, means to an end kind of thing. So would I.
Sometimes 1,000 people must die so 1,000,000 can live.
But only if there's no other way. Saren doesn't even look for another option. He's twisted, broken.
Yeah, I guess.
He likes the violence, the killing. And he knows how to cover his tracks.
Maybe in another life we could have been friends. The leads?
Maybe there's another way to find evidence against Saren.
You should talk to Barla Vaughn over in the financial
district. Not Barla Vaughn. He's an agent for the Shadow Broker.
The Shadow Broker?
Yeah.
An information.
The Shadow Broker.
Buys and sells.
I love that mission in Mass Effect 2. Yes, Mass Effect 2. Where Liara is like a Shadow Broker and you have to like... Liara becomes a new Shadow Broker. You fight that big monster thing. That was cool. I'm looking forward to playing through Mass Effect 2. Mass Effect 1's like, it's a good game, but you know, it gets rather boring.
What? Oh, no, I wasn't. Yes, is there something you want?
Why are you so interested in the Keepers?
Keepers? I've got no interest in the Keep.
Don't get coy. I know what I saw.
I'm not sure I should be talking to you about this.
Just tell me what you're doing. I'm not here to get you into trouble.
All right. I guess it wouldn't hurt to tell you. I'm using a small scanner to gather readings on the Keepers. So far, I've had mixed results. I find it difficult to get near the creatures.
Why were you being so secretive about it, though?
Well, technically, we're not supposed to disturb the Keepers. I don't really think my scanning disturbs them, but the authorities might disagree. I'd like to do it more openly, but it's not really worth getting arrested over.
Yeah, I'll do it.
I can help you out. I'm not worried about the authorities.
I don't even know who you are.
I'm Commander Shepard with the Alliance military.
Hmm. Well, I suppose I could use the help. You'll need this. It's the scanning device I developed. Activate it each time you see a Keeper. All collected data will automatically upload to my database. I'll even send a few credits your way for each unique scan.
Nice.
What are you doing with the data once you've scanned it?
Trying to learn whatever I can about the Keepers. We see them working everywhere, yet we know so little about them. I'm a scientist. I want to know what makes them tick.
Fair enough.
I should get going then.
Yes, I have
yes.
to work myself.
Yes, you should. Fuck off.
So long, and good luck with the scanning.
A gentleman's club in the wards. Hello, assassin. And through. Womp. Yeah. Love it. Hello. Hey, Jenna.
Sorry, I'll get to you when I can.
Oh, you suck.
I got business here, but not with you.
Yeah. Huh.
Commander. What do you want?
Problems?
What's bothering you, General?
I've seen a lot of horrible things in my days, and there's only one woman in this damn galaxy that helps me forget it.
Okay.
So if you feel that way, then why spread lies about her?
Ooh.
She rejected me. Me, Septimus Araka.
Some general. What kind of example are you to your troops?
The troops can kiss my leathery backside. All I wanted was to retire and be with her. Look, kid, I appreciate what you're trying to do, but don't waste your time.
I'll get a grip.
Never let the enemy see your weakness. You know that, General.
Enemies? The one place I always felt at peace was with her. But now, so you think it's that easy? Just straighten up and act like a general?
Yeah, don't be a pussy, basically.
I don't think it could hurt.
Huh. Maybe you're right, Commander. Shaira's worth the effort. Even if she won't have me back.
Fine.
Get up and get moving, General.
Get back out there. Right. Show her who's a real general.
After I've had a cold shower or two. Say, you're a bright kid. Would you be interested in earning a few extra credits?
Oh, absolutely.
What do you want me to do?
There's an Elcor diplomat out there who believes Shaira gave up his secrets.
Why does he think that?
Because I told him. I just need you to convince him of the truth.
I know which one he's talking about.
What makes you think he'll believe me?
You'll bring him proof. Take this data pad. It shows where I got my info. It will exonerate Shaira and convince the Elcor.
Yeah?
Who am I taking it to, and where is he?
His name is Zaltan. He's an Elcor diplomat.
Yes, yes. We've already talked to the bastard.
Well, here's to soldiers acting like soldiers. Thanks, Commander. You know, you might make a good general yourself.
Hell no. General Dragon Lord Shepard? That just sounds stupid.
Hard to imagine a general like that getting so upset about a woman.
Back off, Rex. Fist told us to take you down if you showed up. What are you waiting for? I'm standing right here. This is Fist's only chance. If he's smart, he'll take it. He's not coming out, Rex. End of story. This story is just beginning.
Ah, good old Rex.
Out of my way, humans. I have no quarrel with you.
Hey!
What was that all about?
Who knows? Let's just try not to get caught in the middle.
Yeah, getting caught in the middle of a Krogan fist fight? Not smart. Hey, Harkin.
Alliance military. I could have been a Marine, you know.
Okay.
Instead, I joined the goddamn Citadel Security. Biggest mistake of my life.
Well, yeah, it was your fault, so don't blame me.
I'm looking for a CSEC officer, a Turian named Garrus.
Garrus? You must be one of Captain Anderson's crew. Poor bastard, still trying to bring Saren down, eh? I know where Garrus is, but you gotta tell me something first. Did the captain let you in on his big secret?
Just tell me where Garrus is before this gets ugly.
But it's all related, don't you see? The captain used to be a specter. Didn't know that, did you? It was all very hush-hush. The first human ever given that honor. And then he blew it. Screwed up his mission so bad they kicked him out. Of course, he blames Saren. Says the Turians set him up.
What do you know?
You said they covered all this up. How'd you hear about it?
I spent 20 years working cases here on the Citadel. People on this station love to talk. Secrets are like herpes. You got them, you might as well spread them around.
What?
One more chance. Tell me where Garrus is. Now.
Oh, shit.
Okay, settle down. He went to speak to Dr. Michelle over in the med clinic on the
other
side of the
forgot about her.
What do you know about Garrus?
Damn hothead is what he is. Still figures he can save the world. Always bucking heads with the executor.
Executor.
Lowly field agents in our place. Just look what happened to me.
Shut up.
You need to look in a mirror. Sober up and take some responsibility.
Man in the mirror. Oh.
Save your silence. Yeah, good. Go.
Michael Jackson. Let's get out of here.
I didn't tell anyone, I swear.
Hey, Garrus.
Now, if Garrus comes around, you stay smart. Keep your mouth shut or we'll...
Oh, shit.
Let her go.
Oh, goddamn. Right in the head. Bada-bing! Hip 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 hip. Hippity hip hip hip. Hippity bow. Alright, anything I can take? No? Alright.
Perfect timing, Shepard. Gave me a clear shot at that bastard.
Nice shot.
You took him down clean.
Sometimes you get lucky.
Otherwise, I would have shot the poor doctor in the face. But you know.
No, I'm okay. Thanks to you. All of you.
I know those men threatened you. But if you tell us who they work for, we can protect you.
They work for Feast.
Good old Feast.
They wanted to shut me up. Keep me from telling Garrus about the
quarry. Quarian!
What quarry?
Ah, good old Telly.
A few days ago, a Quarian came by my office. She'd been shot, but she wouldn't tell me who did it. I could tell she was scared, probably on the run. She asked me about the Shadow Broker. She wanted to trade information in exchange for a safe place to hide.
HK.
Where is she now?
I put her in contact with Fist.
Well, that was your mistake, mate. Shadow Broker.
Not anymore. Now he works for Saren. And the Shadow Broker isn't too happy about it.
Fist betrayed the Shadow Broker? That's stupid, even for him. Saren must have made him quite the offer.
That Quarian must have something Saren wants. Something worth crossing the Shadow Broker to get.
She must have something that proves he's a traitor. Did the Quarian mention anything about Saren or the Geth?
She did. The information she was going to trade. She said it had something to do with the Geth.
She must be able to link Saren to the Geth. There is no way the Council can ignore this.
Hell yeah.
Time we paid Fist a visit.
This is your show, Shepard. But I want to bring Saren down as much as you do. I'm coming with you.
Okay.
Welcome, Garrus.
You know, we aren't the only ones going after Fist. The Shadow Broker hired a Krogan bounty hunter named Rex to take him out.
Yeah, we saw him in the bar.
A Krogan might come in handy.
Last I heard, he was at the CSEC Academy.
All right, let's go pick up
Fist accused
Rex.
Him of making threats. We brought Rex in for a little talk. If you hurry, you can catch him at the Academy before he leaves.
Move out.
All right. So, we are obviously taking Garrus. And, who else should we take? Let's have a bit of Aiden. Because then we'll have two Biotic users, two Tech users, and two Soldiery Combat users. Me included, of course. I won't matter in a second because I'm probably going to add Rex to my squad.
I never properly thanked you for saving me from Fist's thugs, Commander. I don't know what would have happened if you hadn't been there.
Happy to help.
I'm just glad you weren't hurt.
Me too. Now, was there anything you needed?
You're a doctor. How did you end up here on the Citadel?
My parents brought me here when I was young. My father was a medic with the Alliance.
A French medic?
Keep the medical tradition alive, but not the military. Fixing up wounded soldiers isn't my idea of fun.
What do you sell?
Let me take a look at what you have for sale.
Of course.
Oh, armor upgrades. I don't care. All right, moving on. Yeah, Emily Wong.
Excuse me, Commander. I'm Emily Wong. I'm an investigative journalist working here on the Citadel. Could I have a moment of your time?
Of course.
What do you need?
I've been hunting for evidence of corruption and organized crime on the Citadel, but there are places I can't go. I was hoping you might share anything you find during your own investigation. I can make it worth your time.
How do you know I'm investigating anything here on the Citadel?
I'm a good journalist, Commander Shepard.
Wow.
How do you know that my investigation is going to uncover anything you need?
You wouldn't be investigating if it weren't big. And if it's big, it's something I'd like to hear about.
We'll see.
No promises. But if I find anything relating to your case, I'll inform you.
Thank you, Commander. You won't regret it.
Good old Emily Wong. Welcome to CSEC. Please enjoy your stay. Hi, Rex.
Witnesses saw you making threats in Fist's bar. Stay away from him.
I don't take orders from you.
This is your only warning, Rex.
You should warn Fist. I will kill him.
You want me to arrest you?
I want you to try.
Rex is awesome.
Go on. Get out of here.
Do I know you, human?
You will.
My name's Shepard. I'm going after Fist. Thought you might want to come along.
Shepard. Commander Shepard. I've heard a lot about you.
Damn fucking straight.
We're both warriors, Shepard. Out of respect, I'll give you a fair warning. I'm going to kill Fist.
Fist knows you're coming. We'll have a better chance if we all work together.
My people have a saying. Seek the enemy of your enemy, and you will find a friend.
Yep. Welcome
aboard. Glad to have you on the team, Rex.
Let's go. I hate to keep Fist waiting.
So I'm gonna take Garrett. I'm gonna take Garrus and Rex. Alien Supreme, right there. Oh, yeah, I should probably like upgrade them too. And apparently me. Sure. Sounds good. Perfect. Perfect. All right.
Okay, Jaleed.
Jaleed.
Hey there. Oh, you're not C-Sec, are you? Did you want something?
I overheard you, even though I actually didn't.
What were you trying to explain to the officer before?
My colleague is trying to kill me.
Cool.
And I thought we were friends.
How do you know he wants you dead?
He's changed. He won't talk to me at work anymore, and he started following me. Yesterday, he followed me all the way home. Just waiting for a chance. I don't care what anyone thinks. He wants me gone. I know it.
How can I help?
Is there something I can do? Talk to your friend, maybe?
Would you? That's all I want. Someone to talk to him. Tell him to leave me alone.
Sure, buddy.
He thinks he can just push me around, but you'll show him, won't you?
Just tell me where he is, and I'll go find him.
Oh, right. Well, he wanted to meet with me down in the wards near the markets. He said he just wanted to talk, but I know better. His name's Shorban. He's
Shorban.
You shouldn't have any trouble. He's just a scientist.
Shorban. That's the guy who wanted us to scam the Keepers.
Ah!
The Keepers?
I mean, I don't know how you know about it. Sure.
To go after him. That's against regulations.
I see.
I better look into this right away. Find out what he's up to.
Anything's possible with Shorban these days. Well, good luck.
Alright then. Hey, C-Sec officer.
Hello, Commander.
Hello? Hey, Shorban. Corbin.
Commander.
Whatever.
I wasn't expecting to see you again. Is there something you want?
I want answers.
You can start by telling me the truth, Shorban.
Yeah, asshole.
I'm not sure what you're referring to. My experiments are...
We're not buying it. Jaleed told us you've been after him.
You spoke with Jaleed? Then you know about the data?
Enough!
Just tell me everything you know.
You boys can go. Looks like my plans have changed. It's not as bad as you think, Commander. Jaleed and I just got a little over our heads.
Keep talking.
The company we work for developed an experimental procedure for use in medical scanners.
Mm-hmm.
Jaleed and I saw even more potential, so we stole the plans and secretly developed a tool to scan the Keepers. Can you imagine? A tool that can actually get readings from the Keepers?
That's it.
That's what all this fuss is about?
The Keepers are almost impossible to scan, and you can't capture them or get samples. They just self-destruct.
What? Jesus.
Here. We still don't know anything about them. Don't you see? We were the first to scan them, ever. You've seen it yourself, Commander. You know we can do it.
Why are you trying to kill your partner?
I'm not trying to kill him. Jaleed's job was to disseminate our initial findings. But he decided to keep the data for himself. Maybe to sell it.
I should kill both of you, idiot.
We lost our heads.
I love Renegade Shepard, he's the best.
Commander, if you'll just continue gathering data for me, imagine what we might learn. And you'll stand to make a bit of a profit yourself, remember?
Oh.
If it'll help further the scientific cause, how can I refuse?
Very good.
Maybe if you wouldn't mind speaking with Jaleed.
Yeah.
It's useless if Jaleed won't help me analyze it.
If I have time, I'll talk to him.
Thank you. And happy scanning, Commander.
Pissed.
I've lost shields.
Oh, fuck. Oh, boy.
Hold the line.
I'm on it.
So much bullets. Oh, God. Alright. Here's what we're gonna do. Someone needs to take out that guy. Yep. And I'll warp him. Yep.
Locked and loaded.
There we go. Alright. Bloody Krogan. You!
I'm on it!
Screw you. Harris. Oh. Thank you, Garrus. Yeah, you're right back there, buddy. Yeah, right. Cool. Ding. Hello.
Stop right there. Don't come any closer.
Warehouse workers. All the real guards must be dead.
Stay back or we'll shoot.
You're making a mistake.
I just killed 50 bodyguards to get in here. What do you think I'll do to you?
Screw Fist. He doesn't pay us enough for this.
It's true.
It would have been quicker to just kill them.
Yeah, but that's fun.
Shooting people isn't always the answer.
Whipping locker. Bye, BB. Aw, shotguns. Dude, Ricks. Ricks, buddy. I'm gonna give you some shotguns. I can have Hurricane. Garrus, what do you use? You use like assault rifles, right? There you go, buddy. You also use sniper rifles, so here you go, buddy.
Look out!
Oh. Sabotage. Boom! I'm so dead.
Lost shield.
Hey, you're fine. Alright.
Wait! Don't kill me, I surrender!
Not talking.
Tell me where the Quarian is, and I won't have to shoot you in the kneecaps.
Hee-hee.
She's not here. I don't know where she is. That's the truth.
He's no use to you now. Let me kill him.
Wait. I don't know where the Quarian is, but I know where you can find her. The Quarian isn't here. Said she'd only deal with the Shadow Broker himself.
Face to face? Impossible. Even I was hired through an agent.
Nobody meets the Shadow Broker. Ever. Even I don't know his true identity. But she didn't know that. I told her I'd set a meeting up. But when she shows up, it'll be Saren's men waiting for her.
You son of a bitch.
Tell me where that meeting is before I blow your lying head off. Here on the wards, the back alley by the markets. She's supposed to meet them right now. You can make it if you hurry.
Sweet. Moving on.
What are you doing?
The Shadow Broker paid me to kill him. I don't leave jobs half done.
A lot of people died because of him. He had it coming.
Yep.
Now let's move. We have to save that Quarian.
Fuck him. That's what I say. One optical disc. First, let's... Hecky heck heck. Oh. I double tapped A then. Ah, fuck it. One. Quarian lost in 3 minutes and 52 seconds. Open. Alright, so let's overkill. Warp.
I'm on it.
Rex, why aren't you using a shotgun, mate? Holy mother of God. Who keeps shooting me to death? Stop, womp. God damn. Enemy is everywhere. Alright. God damn. Cool. Not gonna use any of those. Alright. Tactical arm, I guess. Shield boost. Yeah, give me that shield boost. Should also upgrade these two. Sniper rifles, shotgun, battle master, sure. Run! You must save the Quarian! Tally!
Did you bring it?
Where's the Shadow Broker? Where's Fist?
They'll be here. Where's the evidence?
Ugh.
No way. The deal's off.
You trying to sleep with the Quarian? A little weird. Damn. Alright, well, sabotage. We'll, sabotage. We'll shoot the shit out of them. Oh my god, I blew up. I literally blew up there. What happened there was, blew up. Alright. Hey, at least this time I can, do the safe. That's fun. Alright, same strategy. Sabotage? Actually, no. Shield boost. You sabotage. And not shield boost? Shield boost, mate. Oh shit. Bastard. Oh, I am hit. Very true. Oh. You sabotage. Oh. Well, did technically still use him, so. Hey, run dead.
Just set me up. I knew I couldn't trust him.
There you go.
Were you hurt in the fight?
I like Kelly.
I know how to look after myself. Not that I don't appreciate the help. Who are you?
A friend.
My name's Shepard. I'm looking for evidence to prove Saren's a traitor.
Then I have a chance to repay you for saving my life.
Yeah.
We need to go somewhere safe.
We could take her to the human embassy. Your ambassador will want to see this anyway.
Yeah.
You're not making my life easy, Shepard. Firefights in the wards and all-out assault on Korra's den. Do you know how many?
It's like, this? The hell is this?
What are you up to, Shepard?
Just doing my, actually no, shopping, I'll tell
this
you.
This Quarian can help us bring down Saren. I would have told you that if you had.
I like how I just walk in with three different aliens behind me, none of which this guy's ever met before. Okay, maybe it's Mick Garris. He might know of Rex.
My name is Tali. Tali Zora Naraya.
Naraya.
We don't see many Quarians here. Why did you leave the flotilla?
I was on my pilgrimage, my rite of passage into adulthood.
Nice.
Tell us what you found.
During my travels, I began hearing reports of Geth. Since they drove my people into exile, the Geth have never ventured beyond the Veil. I was curious. I tracked a patrol of Geth to an uncharted world. I waited for one to become separated from its unit. Then I disabled it and removed its memory core.
I thought the Geth fried their memory cores when they died. Some kind of defense mechanism.
How did you manage to preserve the memory core?
My people created the Geth. If you're quick, careful, and lucky, small caches of data can sometimes be saved. Most of the core was wiped clean, but I salvaged something from its audio banks.
Eden Prime was a major victory. The beacon has brought us one step closer to finding the conduit.
Ooh.
That's Saren's voice. This proves he was involved in the attack.
Saren won't get out of this one.
Wait, there's more. Saren wasn't working alone.
Well, then play the whole thing, you crazy bitch. I like you, Tully.
The beacon has brought us one step closer to finding the conduit.
Though this is kind of silly.
And one step closer to the return of the Reapers.
I don't recognize
that other voice, the one talking about Reapers.
I feel like I've heard that name before.
According to the Memory Core, the Reapers were a hyper-advanced machine race that existed 50,000 years ago. The Reapers hunted the Protheans to total extinction, and then they vanished. At least, that's what the Geth believe.
Sounds a little far-fetched.
The vision on Eden Prime. I understand.
It all makes sense now.
I saw the Protheans being wiped out by the Reapers.
The Geth revere the Reapers as gods, the pinnacle of non-organic life. And they believe Saren knows how to bring the Reapers back.
The Council is just going to love this.
This is a lot to handle. They might just ignore everything we tell them.
No matter what they think about the rest of this, those audio files prove Saren's a traitor.
The Captain's right. We need to present this to the Council right away.
What about her, the Quarian?
My name is Tali.
You will refer to me as Tali.
You saw me in the alley, Commander. You know what I can do. Let me come with you.
What about your quest?
I thought you were on your pilgrimage.
The pilgrimage proves we are willing to give of ourselves for the greater good. What does it say about me if I turn my back on this?
You make a good point.
Saren is a danger to the entire galaxy. My pilgrimage can wait.
I'll take all the help I can get.
Sweet.
Thanks. You won't regret this.
Henderson and I will go ahead to get things ready with the Council. Take a few minutes to collect yourself, then meet us in the tower.
Yes, sir. Alright. So, we'll take a good old Tally. And we'll also take... We'll take Garrus. Tally and Garrus. This is our squad. Tally and Garrus. Until we get, you know, the hour, but we good. I am. We're back here, so we can talk to this asshole. Do 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 do. You.
Strange greeting, human. This is really not a good time.
I know who revealed your secret. It was a Turian named Septimus.
Unbelieving. I know this Septimus, and he could not learn my secrets. The only way he could learn them is from the Asari consort.
Here, there should be proof enough for you.
Confused. This is difficult to fathom.
That's a good word.
If the Turian,
we should use fathom more often. Own,
dismayed. Anyone can discover my secret.
You'll be fine.
Septimus is a powerful man, and it wasn't easy for him to find.
Relieved. I suppose you are correct, human. Thank you for this information. Startled realization. I must speak with the consort. She will be most displeased with my actions. Anxious request. Please, human, if you will excuse me, I must go now.
Bye.
So long.
Farewell, human.
Boom.
Thankful. That was a great thing you did, Commander. Approving. You see, Din, not all humans are as you say.
I'm sure the Earth Clan stands to profit from this in some way.
We're nearly done with the Citadel, and thank God for that. The first trip to the Citadel, actually every trip to the Citadel sucks. Gonna be updated. Guys, please stop getting in my way. Hey, look, it's Samish.
Excuse me, Commander Shepard. Could you spare a moment of your time? Commander Shepard, my name is Samish Bhatia. Forgive the intrusion, but I have nowhere else to turn.
I'm listening.
What do you need?
My wife was a Marine. She was in the 212 on Eden Prime. I've requested that my wife's body be returned to me for cremation, but the military has refused my request.
Why did they refuse your request? There's got to be some reason.
I don't know. All I know is that they have declared it impossible for my wife to be returned to me.
We'll look into it.
The man in charge of my case is Mr. Bosker. When I last saw him, he was in the expensive bar over there. Thank you for your time.
Where?
I just want
to. All right, yeah, I vaguely remember that bar.
And the respect she deserves.
To the bar, humbug. Ba-ding. Oh, damn. Paladin.
Commander Shepard, I didn't expect to see you here. Did Ambassador Udina send you?
No. I go where I want.
Nobody sends me anywhere. I just need some information.
You humans are always so curious, always sticking your fingers into someone else's pie. Never mind. Forget I asked. Was there something you needed, Commander?
Tell me about your investigation into Saren.
Sorry, Commander. I don't make a habit of giving out details about ongoing investigations.
No.
I get the feeling you're not too fond of humans.
No, I just don't trust your kind. Not yet. You humans are eager to take all the power you can get, and you're being given a lot. If the Council wants to make humanity their new favorite pet, that's their business. But I don't have to like it.
The Council treats us like second-class citizens. We have to fight for everything we get.
Good. Then fight for it. But don't expect the rest of us to just sit back and let you take it. I'm a busy man, Commander. Are we done here?
What a dick.
I'll be going now.
Goodbye, Commander.
Goodbye. Is anything... How? Ah, easy description. But before we do the easy description, I'm gonna save. Begin override. BBY. The following message was transmitted from an untraceable account to multiple recipients across the extranet. Further monitoring of the situation is warranted. My fellow Biotic, you have been selected to receive this transmission because of our shared plight. You understand us. You tolerate us. We must stand together. We must build our own new world. Come, join us in the Hawking Eta Cluster. Only as one body can we right the wrongs done to our kind. Well, I know where I have to go then. Let's upgrade Telly while we're here. Hey, it's Private Fredericks.
What do you want?
What?
Commander.
What asshole?
Is there something I can do for you?
What can you tell me about the Asari consort?
Well, she's an Asari who
works
here.
Yes.
That is, she helps people with...
Yeah?
You never went to see her, did you?
No, I never did. I couldn't afford it. It costs half a year's credits just to go in and talk to her.
That's fine, Private. Just tell me where to find
her. Wait, what?
Sure. She's across the bridge from the embassies.
Why? What? Was I supposed to come here, like, before? Wait, who cares?
My goodness, you're Commander Shepard.
I am.
Activities made for quite a briefing in the diplomatic corps. Is there something I can do to assist you?
Yes. A man named Samish Bhatia is having some trouble claiming his wife's body.
Ah, Mr. Bhatia. A good man in an understandably frustrating position. I wish I could help him, Serviceman Nirali Bhatia died on Eden Prime, as Mr. Bhatia no doubt told you. Her wounds are inconsistent with any type of weapon damage we've seen before. That is why her body is being held.
You're studying her injuries to learn more about Geth weaponry.
The tests we're conducting may lead to better defenses against Geth attacks. Respectfully, Serviceman Bhatia may save more lives in death than she did in life.
That's cool and all, but, yeah.
How long do you think the research is going to take?
This is a long-term study.
Ah.
I wouldn't expect the bodies to be released for a year or longer.
Yeah, I'm releasing the body.
You know who and what I
am. Jesus!
If I want Nirali Bhatia, I can get her.
Commander, I don't think threats are necessary. Even if the body were here on the Citadel, would you really risk going in shooting to get it?
The Marine's name was Nirali Bhatia. If you want to cut her up, you call her by name.
All right, Commander. You win.
I always win.
It was hard enough refusing Mr. Bhatia. I'm not going to risk an incident by refusing. Tell Sumesh that the body is being shipped back to Earth.
Yeah.
I'll go now to see to it myself.
Bam, strike. Alright, is that everyone? I think that's... Oh, no. It's still this bitch.
Time to talk now.
Okay. Very busy. Can't talk to her yet. Hey, Mr. Bhatia! Hello.
Hello again, Commander. Has there been any word?
I took care of it.
Your wife is coming home, Mr. Bhatia.
Thank you. I will return home and begin my preparations. It does not bring me happiness, but it may bring me peace.
I mean, probably not, but yeah.
Goodbye, Commander.
You gonna give me money or XP? Well, I'll take it. Now the time to have some sexy times. Also, there was a question mark back then, but that's absolutely fine. Actually, no, it was up here. We good. We good. We good. Hello. Chaira.
Commander, I recently received a lovely note from Septimus. Thank you for speaking with him. Even the Alcor diplomat has withdrawn his campaign against me.
Let's talk payment.
I can't spend gratitude.
I would not dream of letting you go without payment. I do not make a habit of incurring debts. These credits will cover your expenses.
Nice.
I also have one more thing to give you, if you are interested.
Very.
I'd be honored.
I offer a gift of words, an affirmation of who you are and who you will become.
Sure.
I see your skin, tough as the scales on any Turian, unyielding. A wall between you and everyone else, but it protects you, makes you strong. You never hide your strength, either. It serves you well, terrifies your foes. Few will dare to stand against you.
That's right.
This may be who you are, but it is not who you will become. It only forms the basis for your future greatness.
Nice.
Remember these words when doubt descends, Commander.
Very astute.
You have quite a gift, Chaira.
Thank you. Not everyone appreciates it as you do.
Mm-hmm.
Never underestimate the power of words. Here, Commander. In light of your efforts with the Alcor Ambassador, I would like you to have this small trinket.
What is it?
A small mystery. I have never learned its use or purpose, but I sense it is time for me to pass it on. And now I must ask you to leave. I have done everything I can for you.
I think this is the thing that activates like a weird, like, glass ball thing.
They will give you strength.
Really? I can't bang you? Well, alright. That's disappointing. Very, very disappointing. Let's see. We'll level up the decryption, assault rifles, pistols. Alright. Now we go to Seasick Academy. You dun dun.
Hello again. Did you have any luck finding Shorben?
Of course.
I found out you've been lying to me, Jaleed.
Lying? Why would I lie to you?
You forgot to mention the data about the Keeper.
He told you? I didn't mean for any of this to happen. I was afraid Shorben would kill me to get the data, so I... Well, I was hoping you'd take care
of it. Wow!
I'm scanning the Keepers for Shorben, but you two need to stop fighting.
You're helping us? But, well, if you say so. Well, if Shorben can forgive and forget, then so can I. I appreciate the help, Commander. I better go get that data analyzed.
It sounds like he's a million miles away. What the hell was that? Alright, now we got one more side quest to do, and then I think we're finally done on the Citadel. There's still, I think, like one or two more side quests left, but one of them it's best to do later, and the other one I'm not even sure it exists. Oh, the Keepers, yeah, the Keepers I can do now, but wait, can I do it now? I might not actually be able to do it now. So, yeah. Ah, I forgot about Lux. Oops.
Word on the street is that you've been busy. Congratulations on taking down Fisk.
Thanks.
I was sure he was a big player in anything going on here. Did you find anything in his office that could help me?
Found some discs.
These OSDs might have the information you're looking for.
You've got Fisk files? This could be even bigger than I'd hoped. Here, Commander, for your trouble.
Thank you. You owe me more.
I had to kill people for these discs. They're worth more than you're offering.
I didn't tell you to kill Fisk. But you're right. I suppose that I did ask you to help me, so... Here, this should be more than adequate. Now, if you'll excuse me, I should go see what's on these discs.
Laters. Ah, I love being a renegade. Fun times. Alright, I think there's one more side quest in here. Oh, listen to that music! Look at that loading screen! Hi, Rita.
Sorry, I'm kind of busy right now. So, what can I do for you?
What were you discussing with the Volus?
Who, Doran? Oh, I was just asking him about my sister. See, she worked for Doran before she left to... sorry. I don't want to bore you with my problems.
Go on.
I'm interested to hear what you have to say.
Well, okay. My sister Jenna left here to go work at Cora's den.
I met Jenna.
The problem is, she's working as an informant for CSEC. You know, eavesdropping on the people there. If they find out what she's doing, they'll kill her.
I assume CSEC is protecting her?
They can't watch her all the time. I don't know. Sometimes I think she stays there just to spite me.
Do you know who her contact at CSEC is?
No. It's all very secret. Last time I asked an officer, he told me to stay out of it, for Jenna's safety.
Leave it to me.
Maybe I could help her understand just how dangerous Cora's den is.
Would you? That'd be great. Just don't tell her I sent you. Well, I should get back to work before I get in trouble.
Alright. Anyone else over here? No? Cool. Alright.
Hi, I'll be with you in just a sec.
I need to talk to you about your work with CSEC.
I don't know what you're talking about. Now, if you don't mind, I need to get back to my customers.
This isn't a game, Jenna. These people are dangerous.
Now you sound like my sister. Why is everyone so concerned about me? I can take care of myself. I need to go. I'm not a stripper. I don't get paid to stand around and look pretty.
She puts on a brave face.
I'm busy. The other waitresses can help you.
Well, I didn't really get through to her, now did I? Back to the hip-a-da-dip! Oh, hang on. Shellac! Hey, buddy.
If you've got questions about Jenna, meet me at CSEC Academy.
What did you just say?
Push off! I never did nothing to you. Damn newcomers. Think they can run the place.
That was odd. What was he trying to tell us?
I guess we'd better go find out.
Alright, to CSEC. Oh, I bet it's the empty office. Is it? It is. Ha ha.
Detective Shellac, come into my office. I want to discuss this in private. No offense, Commander, but what the hell were you thinking?
Careful.
Watch your tone, Shellac.
You could have blown Jenna's cover.
We were just getting information, Shellac.
I gathered that. It might seem cold letting her take all the risk. We're keeping a close eye on her.
It's too dangerous. You need to find another way.
It's not that simple, Shepard. This job isn't easy, and it's usually unpleasant. I'll take help anywhere I can find it. But since you're so concerned with her safety, maybe there's a way we can help each other.
Oh, God.
Always thinking ahead, Detective. Here we go.
It's part of the job. Now, are you going to help me or not?
Oh. Well, that's awkward. Huh. What do you need?
I'll help you, but I need some details.
I'm trying to track down an illegal arms producer. I just need some of their product. Thanks to Jenna's intel, I've learned there's a seller here on the Citadel. Meet our man named Jax. Pick up the
nice.
Rods and bring them back here. That'll give me everything I need.
Go, Jax.
I'll persuade Jax to tell me where these mods are coming from.
No. You tip Jax off, and all my leads will disappear faster than you can say bad bust.
Yeah.
Why are you so concerned about these mods?
We have access to some of the most sophisticated weaponry there is. That's what gives us our edge. What do you suppose happens when we lose that edge?
These give criminals an advantage we can't afford to let them keep.
Fair enough.
Where can I find this, Jax?
Jax is down in the lower level of the markets. I'll send word through our channels that you're the buyer. Good luck, Commander.
Hey, alright, here we go. Oh, god damn. Hey, Jax.
Hold it. That's close enough, Army. You got my payment?
Do you have the X-Mods?
Show them the merchandise.
Looks good.
Damn straight it is. These mods are the best on the market. Now hand over my credits.
I don't think so.
I'll just take the weapons.
The hell are you playing at?
You heard me.
Sorry, Jax. This is the end for you.
Stupid ass army boy. Kill him.
Dampening. Oh, now let's overload. Sabotage and... Warp. Holy mother of god, that a lot of things just happened. I have been hit, you're right. Can I use my thank you? Sweet. Explosion.
What the hell happened down there, Commander?
Yeah, I didn't like him.
Jax needed killing. Here's your shipment.
Damn it. I've got to get on this right away before Jax's superiors get wind of his death.
What about our deal?
Jenna will be removed from harm's way. You've put me in a bit of a bind here, Commander.
Yeah, well, fuck you.
See yourself out when you're ready.
That's what you get. Listen, I've done a lot of quests here. I just wanna be a spectre and get the hell out of this bloody station. Alright? Ain't got time for following the rules, man.
Come on. Udina's presenting the Quarians ever.
I feel like we've used this exact same shot once before.
Aiden Prime was a major victory. The beacon has brought us one step closer to finding the conduit.
And one step closer to the return of the Reapers.
You wanted proof? There it is.
This evidence is irrefutable, Ambassador. Saren will be stripped of his Spectre status, and all efforts will be made to bring him in to answer for his crimes.
I recognize the other voice, the one speaking with Saren. Matriarch Benezia.
Oh, the traitor.
She must be working with the Geth, too.
Matriarch Benezia is a powerful biotic, and she had many followers. She will make a formidable ally for Saren.
I'm more interested in the Reapers. What do you know about them?
Only what was extracted from the Geth's memory core. The Reapers were an ancient race of machines that wiped out the Protheans. Then they vanished.
The Geth believe the Reapers are gods, and Saren is the prophet for their return.
We think the conduit is the key to bringing them back. Saren's searching for it. That's why he attacked Eden Prime.
Do we even know what this conduit is?
Saren thinks it can bring back the Reapers. That's bad enough.
Listen to what you're saying. Saren wants to bring back the machines that wiped out all life in the galaxy? Impossible. It has to be. Where did the Reapers go? Why did they vanish? How come we found...
Look at that guy's teeth! Jesus! I never noticed that before. They're like bloody sharks in there. Don't be a fool! You doubted me before.
I tried to warn you about Saren and you refused to face the truth. Don't make the same mistake again.
This is different. You proved Saren betrayed the Council. We all agree he's using the Geth to search for the conduit, but we don't really know why.
The Reapers are obviously just a myth, Commander. A convenient lie to cover Saren's true purpose. A legend he is using to bend the Geth to his will.
50,000 years ago, the Reapers wiped out all galactic civilization. If Saren finds the conduit, it will happen again.
Saren is a rogue agent on the run for his life. He no longer has the rights or resources of a Spectre. The Council has stripped him of his position.
That is not good enough. You know he's hiding somewhere in the Traverse. Send your fleet in!
A fleet cannot track down one man.
It's true.
A Citadel fleet could secure the entire region, keep the Geth from attacking any more of our colonies.
Or it could trigger a war with the Terminus systems. We won't be dragged into a galactic confrontation over a few dozen human colonies.
Send me.
I can take Saren down.
The commander's right. There is a way to stop Saren that doesn't require fleets or armies.
No, it's too soon. Humanity is not ready for the responsibilities that come with joining the Spectres.
Except we had a human Spectre before.
Saren,
I mean, he failed.
And exposed him for a traitor. I've proven myself.
Here we go. Music's amping up.
Commander Shepard, step forward. It is the decision of the Council that you be granted all the powers and privileges of the Special Tactics and Reconnaissance Branch of the Citadel.
Spectres are not trained, but chosen. Individuals forged in the fire of service and battle. Those whose actions elevate them above the rank and file.
Spectres are an ideal, a symbol, the embodiment of courage, determination, and self-reliance. They are the right hand of the Council, instruments of our will.
Spectres bear a great burden. They are protectors of galactic peace, both our first and last line of defense. The safety of the galaxy is theirs to uphold.
You are the first human Spectre, Commander. This is a great accomplishment for you and your entire species.
I'm honored, Counselor.
Let's not be rude before,
we're
out of here.
He's a fugitive from justice, so you are authorized to use any means necessary to apprehend or eliminate him.
I'll find him.
Laters.
This meeting of the Council is adjourned.
Peace.
Congratulations, Commander.
We've got a lot of work to do, Shepard. You're going to need a ship, a crew, supplies.
You'll get access to special equipment and training now. You should go down to the CSEC Academy and speak to the Spectre requisition.
Yeah, no, I'm good.
Anderson, come with me.
I'll
set all this up.
I'll deal with that later. Fuck that guy.
I thought the ambassador would be a little more grateful. He didn't even thank you.
Yeah, he's kind of an asshole.
What do you expect from a politician? Come on.
Right behind you, Shepard.
Yay. Dude, look at this. Bop. Nice. Alright, oh, actually, no. Sniper rifles, yeah. And Terrian agent. Nice. Whee! Wait, Docking Bay is up.
Do you regret leaving Citadel Security to pursue Saren, Garrus?
I mean, he just left. Like, he literally is just, like, I don't even know if he's formally left yet.
I'm pleased that the imminent destruction of all organic life has improved your career opportunities.
Nice one. God, it's blue.
Captain, news for you, Shepard. Captain Anderson is stepping down as commanding officer of the Normandy. The ship is yours now.
She's quick and quiet, and you know the crew. Perfect ship for a Spectre. Treat her well, Commander.
This isn't right. The Normandy belongs to you.
You needed your own ship. A Spectre can't answer to anyone but the Council. And it's time for me to step down.
Come clean with me, Captain. You owe me that much.
I was in your shoes 20 years ago, Shepard. They were considering me
for 20 years ago, good God.
What happened?
I failed. I couldn't make the cut. It's not something I'm proud of. Ask me later and I'll tell you the whole story. For now, all you need to know is, I was sent on a mission with Saren, and he made sure the Council rejected me. I had my shot. It came and went. Now you have a chance to make up for my mistakes.
Saren will pay.
Saren's not going to get away this time.
Saren's gone. Don't even try to find him. But we know what he's after. The Conduit. He's got his Geth scouring the Traverse looking for clues.
We had reports of Geth in the Pharos system shortly before our colony there dropped out of contact, and there have been sightings around Novaria.
Find out what Saren was after on Pharos and Novaria. Maybe you can figure out where the Conduit is before he does.
The Reapers are the real threat.
I'm with the Council on this one, Shepard. I'm not sure they even exist.
But if they do exist, the Conduit's the key to bringing them back. Stop Saren from getting the Conduit, and we stop the Reapers from returning.
I'll stop him.
We have one more lead. Matriarch Benezia, the other voice in that recording?
Yeah.
She has a daughter, a scientist who specializes in Protheus. We don't know if she's involved, but it might be a good idea to try and find her. See what she knows. Her name's Liara, Dr. Liara Tassoni.
Mm-hmm.
We have reports she was exploring an archaeological dig on one of the uncharted worlds
that
in the Artemis Tau cluster.
Will be where
sounds
I go
like we should head for
to
the Artemis Tau cluster.
Just saying, decision, Commander. We need a hot Asari on our team.
You don't answer to us.
But your actions still reflect on humanity as a whole. You make a mess and I get stuck cleaning it up.
That's a job, bitch.
I'll take care of Saren. You take care of the political fallout.
Not exactly the answer I was looking for, Shepard. Remember, you were a human long before you were a Spectre.
And you were an asshole long before I was born,
so. Captain Anderson can answer any questions you might have.
Well, see ya, Captain. I have no questions. Ooh, inspect. Let's go. And Normandy. Oh, it's so good to be off the bloody Citadel. Like, you have no idea. In the last, like, 2 hours there. Christ.
I heard what happened to Captain Anderson. Survives 100 battles and then gets taken down by backroom politics.
Yeah, just the way the cookie crumbles, man.
Things go bad on this mission, you're next on their chopping block.
Captain Anderson should be the one in charge. It's like I'm stealing the ship from him.
Yeah, the captain got screwed. But it's not like you could have stopped it. Nobody's blaming you. Everyone on this ship's behind you, Commander. 100%. Intercom's open. If you got anything you want to say to the crew, now's the time.
Listen up, Normandy. This is your commander speaking. We have our orders. Find Saren before he finds the Conduit, and I refuse to let anything get in the way of that mission. The Council wants to ignore this. That's no surprise. They've never helped us in the past. No reason they'd start now. But we don't need their help. We can do this on our own. We all know what happened on Eden Prime. We saw the destruction, we saw the bodies, we saw what Saren did. And I plan to make him pay. Wherever Saren goes, we'll follow. Wherever he searches for the conduit, we'll be there. We will hunt him to the very ends of the galaxy and bring him down. This is the most important mission any of us have ever been on. The fate of an entire galaxy is at stake. We will stop Saren, no matter what the cost.
Well said, Commander. Captain will be proud.
The captain gave up everything so I could have this chance. We can't fail.
Let's do this!
Yes, sir.
Away!